Hi students, welcome to my channel. I wish you all the best. Yesterday I posted one model paper in physical science for AP IIIT. Today the second model paper in physical science for AP IIIT. Once again, I wish you all the best. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. So today's second model paper, the first bit on the screen, which of the following compound is formed by ionic bond? Ionic bandham to erpade padartham edi annadma. Yeah, tell me. Yeah, very good. It is magnesium oxide. In it there is an ionic bond, so electron transfer from magnesium to oxygen. Remaining three are formed by the covalent bond, ma H2O covalent molecule, covalent bond undi. Ammonia covalent molecule, covalent bond undi. HCl covalent bond undi. Next, which of the following is correct order of repulsive interactions? So you know that lone pair occupy more space around the central atom. Lone pairs occupy more space around the central atom, hence lone pair repulsion is greater than the lone pair bond pair repulsion, greater than the bond pair repulsion. So option A is correct. Next question on the screen. Match the following electronic theory of valency. Tell me. Yeah, it is proposed by Cosell and Lewis. Valency bond theory. It is proposed by Linus Pauling. Vesper theory, valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, proposed by Sitjivik and Powell. So option B, A, C. There is no option. So here Vesper theory was proposed by Sitjivik and Powell, and then it is developed by Glipsy and Nyholm. Next question on the screen. What will happen if we give energy to the ice at -15°C? So initially the ice is at -15°C. When we give energy means heated, the temperature increases from -15°C to 0°C. Once the temperature of the ice reaches 0°C, ice starts melting. So during the process of melting, the temperature remains constant. So initially the temperature of the ice increases from -15°C to 0°C, then remains constant. So the option A is correct. Next question on the screen. Temperature of the mixture is 70°C. Resultant temperature is one liquid of 100 ml at 90°C and second liquid at 60°C is mixed together, then the quantity of the second mixture is unknown. You know that resultant temperature T is equal to, according to law of methods of mixture, resultant temperature T is equal to m1 t1 plus m2 t2 by m1 plus m2 annamata. So here it is T resultant temperature of the mixer T ichinadu. It is m1 ichinadu. It is T1 ichinadu. Then it is T2 ichinadu. find M2 annadu. Quantity of the second mixture, second liquid in one. M2 kanukovalla. If you substitute these values in this equation and simplify it, we get the answer C, 200 ml annamata. On adding of 2 ml of sulfuric acid to 10 ml of water. So sulfuric acid 2 ml iskoni 10 ml of water kalipinamu. Which of the following observation is true? So acid water mixes em avutundi, homogeneous mixture erpadutundi. Homogeneous mixture erpadutundi. So transparent solution is formed, white precipitate, it is wrong. To separate layers wrong, colorless water gas available, it is wrong. So option A is correct. So water and acid mixed in all proportions to form transparent solution. Next question on the screen. Do not store pickles in the sore substances in a metal vessel. You know that pickles and sore substances contain acids. When they are stored in metal vessels, they react with metals to form salts which are poisonous in nature. Next, acids react with metal and releases H2 gas. So both assertion and reason are correct. And R supports A. So option A is correct. Next question is, in the diagram, the correctly marked angles are I, angle of incident, or angle of refraction, then E, it is wrongly marked. So I and R. Option A is correct. Next question on the screen. So here observe the diagram. So light ray entering from one medium to another medium. So it is the straight line path. So it means the light ray bends towards the normal. So when does the light ray bends towards the normal? Tell me, when the light ray enters from rarer medium to denser medium, rarer to denser medium, then only light ray bends towards the normal due to change in speed here, decrease in speed. So rarer medium nunchi, it is the rarer medium. Painundedi rarer medium. Krindundedi denser medium. So rarer nunchi denser layer ku vachinappudu bends towards the normal due to decrease in speed. So guess the medium at the bottom of the interface AB. Tell me, denser medium. If the refracted ray from a convex lens is traveling parallel to the principal axis, then the image is formed. Tell me, ekkada convex lens image ekkada erpadutundama? Parallel to principal axis. So equal to focal length of the lens. Equal to focal length of the lens. Next question on the screen. So there is one diagram. Correct path of the refracted ray. Here if you observe that it is the convex lens. Convex lens. So light ray entering in the direction of the focus. Light ray entering into the means incident on the convex lens in a direction of focus. So light ray which passes through the focus or incident in the direction of the focus after refraction passes parallel to the principal axis. So option B is correct. So after refraction here, it passes parallel to the, it is the principal axis, parallel to principal axis. Next question, which part of the omni controls the entering light rays into the eye? Iris controls the light entering into the eye. Next, biconvex lens are used to correct hypermetropia. It is correct. biconvex lens form the image of an object at far point. It is the wrong at near point undala, at near point undala. So option A is correct. A is correct, but R is wrong. Option A is correct, but reason is wrong. Assertion is wrong. Correct. Next question on the screen. The electromagnetic spectrum consists of both visible light, invisible light, like X-rays, gamma rays, visible light, and the X-rays, gamma rays, IR rays, and UV rays, microwaves, and radio waves. In rakala electromagnetic waves, among these, the radiation with large wavelength. Tell me, radiation with large wavelength. So radio waves have large wavelength. Radio waves have large wavelength, while gamma rays have shorter wavelength. Bohr-Sommerfeld model of an atom for n is equal to 2. So n is equal to 2 means two shells undala. One must be circular, another one must be elliptical. So option B is correct. So as n is equal to 2, it must have two shells. So according to Bohr-Sommerfeld, one must be circular, another one must be elliptical. B, which one of the following element has more electropositive? Metals are more electropositive. Here potassium is the metal which is more electropositive. Remaining are non-metals. They are less electropositive. They are more electronegative. Differentiating electron of some elements are given below. Sodium 3s1, aluminium 3p1, scandium 3d1. Cerium 4F2. Then correct indication of their blocks. So you know that in sodium, the differentiating electron, last electron enter into s orbital, 3s orbital. So it is s black. Aluminium into p, so p black. Scandium into 3d, so d black. Cerium into 4F, so f black. Option A is correct. Option A is correct. Next. The VI characteristics of four circuit elements are shown below. Which among the following is ohmic conductor? So for ohmic conductor, the graph between potential difference and current is a straight line passing through the origin. So among these, option C is the correct, the straight line passing through origin. Next question on the screen. The specific resistance does not change. Specific resistance does not change. The material is changed, temperature is changed, shape of the resistor changed, both material and temperature are changed. So when does it does not change? Eppudu maradu? When the shape of the resistor is changed. Whatever it means, the shape, resistance is, specific resistance is same. So resistor yaka a shape lo unna kuda specific resistance maradu. Match the following and select correct option. Force on moving charge. Force on moving charge. Force on moving charge B annamata. Tesla, Newton per ampere per meter square meter. Next, permanent magnet, Alnico. Then force on a current carrying conductor, Bill. So this is the option. So where is this? 1B, 2C, 3D. So option B is correct. Option B is correct. Next question on the screen. Here observe the, it is magnetic field lines due to current carrying wire. Magnetic field lines due to current carrying wire. So here current is into the phase, downward direction. So field lines are in clockwise direction. Next one, it is the magnetic field lines due to external source, a horseshoe magnet. Magnetic field lines due to horseshoe magnet. Here in the upper portion of these these, if you observe that here the direction of the magnetic field lines is the direction lo untai, external magnetic field is also in the same direction. So above this here, the both will be coincide, that is direction of the magnetic field line due to current carrying wire and direction of the magnetic field line due to external source. So here due to horseshoe magnet is coincide here. So a strong field is developed. So below this here, if you observe the magnetic field lines due to current carrying wire is in this direction. This is in, so these two are in opposite direction. So each one cancel each other. So the field becomes weak. Totally the magnetic field due to current carrying wire due to external field becomes non-uniform. In this, the drawing of the resulting field is option C. So here, as both the direction of the magnetic field lines are coincide each other, the field becomes strong. Here opposite each other, the field becomes weak. The impurity, that is gang, is acidic. So if the gang impurity is acidic, then the flux used is basic flux wadala. So the gang, that is impurity present in the ore, is acidic. Basic flux is used. Here the basic flux is calcium oxide, CaO. Next question, aluminum is more reactive than iron, but rate of corrosion of iron is more than aluminum. So aluminum iron kanna ekkuva reactive aina kuda, corrosion lo iron is more than aluminum. This is due to, so initially both of them slightly undergo corrosion. As a result, here corrosion is an oxidation process, means iron and aluminum reacts with oxygen of the air. Then their oxides are formed as a layer on their surface. So iron corrosion jarinappudu iron meeda iron oxide anedi oka layer ga coating erpadutundi. Alage aluminum metal meeda aluminum oxide layer anedi erpadutundi. But the aluminum oxide layer is stable. It is stable. Hence, it is less corrosive than iron. So aluminum forms a stable oxide layer on the surface of the aluminum metal. Hence, then the further corrosion is prevented. Next question on the screen. The IUPAC name of the compound is, so here double bond in the preference will be given during numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here after 1 there is a double bond, third carbon 2 bromine substituents are there, and fourth carbon there is 2 chloride substituents. So in alphabetical order, bromine B must come before C. So 3,3-dibromo, 4,4-dichloro, pent 1-ene, 5 carbons I got pent 1-ene. Next, unsaturated organic compounds undergo substitution reaction. It is wrong, ma. Unsaturated organic compounds undergo addition reaction. It is assertion is wrong. The reason, unsaturated organic compounds contain double or triple bonds. It is correct. So assertion is wrong, but reason is true. So option D is correct. Okay, thank you. Once again, I wish you all the best. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Okay.